Welcome back to Outdoors with Larry Ray on ESPN 790 AM. Brought to you proudly by Sportsman's Warehouse, Counts Marine, the Tennessee Wildlife Resources Agency, and Avery Superstore.
Hey, welcome back to Outdoors with Larry Ray. And man, that was, it's always fun to talk about the St. Jude Bass Classic. Because all the work that those bass fishermen will be doing tomorrow on Sardis Lake to raise all that money for St. Jude Children's Research Hospital, it's just remarkable. And I will guarantee you that there will be some folks down there because the weather, we've just gone from spring to summer in a leap.
Overnight.
Overnight. How humid. And so
2 weeks ago, I wore a jacket a few days.
Well, now, if you don't have, I guarantee you, it's Sardis tomorrow. There will be some folks with fish monkey gloves on, have fish monkey all over them, and have the fish monkey mask or whatever you want to call it, because now they've invented a little mouthpiece. And I am the fish monkey man here in Memphis, thanks to not only Ron Wong, who introduced me to fish monkey, but the fish monkey man himself. I don't know if he likes being called that or not.
Tim
Mossberg, the president and our good friend out of Destin, Florida, with Fish Monkey. Good morning, Tim.
Good morning, Larry and Ron. Hey, listen, I've been called worse, so I'll take it.
We don't want to know what you've been called, okay? I mean, I don't want to lose
it. I don't think we can say it on air.
No. We'll talk about it because we're in that time that your product is really out there as we hit the Memorial Weekend when so many people will be out and they're not going to be protected. So talk a little bit about the product itself and how we're going and what's happening in 2019 at Fish Monkey.
All right. Well, again, thanks for having us on. So the product's doing great, and this is the time of year where so many people start thinking about, or they think about sun protection once they're on the boat or out on the lake or on the water. And so the gloves that we've created – especially in our guide glove series, which we have about five different styles and a ton of different colors in that.
Let me get my gloves on right now. I'm wearing my gloves.
So those gloves on the back of the hand, which is the area that's more susceptible to the sun.
Yes.
It's the thinner part of your skin. Mm-hmm. The back of the gloves has a UPF 50 sun protection made into the fabric. Into the fabric. So instead of having to apply a sunscreen on your hand, which will typically you're going to wash off or it's going to fade after a good hour's use anyway, you don't have to worry about doing that because the gloves are going to give you the protection that the sunscreen normally would, but it's going to last all day. So as long as you've got the gloves on, you've got sun protection. And then new for this year, because the sun protection of the hands is so important, new for this year, we came out with what's called our Face Guard product that now offers you sun protection for your face, your ears, the top of your nose, your head, the back of your neck, the whole nine yards. So now you can basically wrap your head in the same type of sun protection that you're able to wrap your hand in.
And you've got the mouthpiece thing like now. I mean, there's...
Absolutely. So what we did is there were several different styles that were out there on the market, and I'm a big believer in that type of product, wearing it all the time. But when you wear it and you pull it up tied up under your sunglasses, it would fog your sunglasses.
Yeah.
And so what we did is we actually put a vented air piece in the front so it allows the breath to escape and not fog your glasses nearly as bad.
Okay, I've got to order one of those
because those are cool.
I have an awful time with the normal type of sun.
Most people quit wearing them. I brought along my Costa sunglasses. Okay, there.
Yeah. Bifocal.
Bifocals. Yeah, I've got them. And so when I wear these, I tried it out. He knows I'm claustrophobic and things along that line. I will say, it did not fog these glasses.
That's awesome.
Ron. Nice.
I mean,
nice.
That's what it's all about. You know.
And what did you do now? You've just put a little. Is it just air holes like thing?
So it's just a series of perforated holes.
Yeah.
Just around where your nose and your mouth are, and they're They're not large. They're small enough so it continues to block the sun.
It was amazing.
But at the same time, it allows your breath to escape the fabric quicker. The fabric itself is breathable, so it's not like wearing a plastic bag around your head.
Right.
It's
actually
breathable fabric. But the air holes allow the breath to escape quicker. Therefore, it's not traveling up and fogging your sunglasses.
Well, just be sure when you go next door and see your neighbor and you still got on your mask that he knows who you are. You know what I mean?
Right.
But it still beats face paint.
Hey, Tim.
It does beat face paint. And I will say that this thing, and Ron's going to ask you something real question. Not only is it protect your face, but you can make it into a do-rag. You know, you can tie it around your head or anything like that. I've put it around neck or whatever it might be like that because I don't sunburn. I'm really, really fortunate to not sunburn. I tan, and I'm either out golfing or whatever it might be, but it's amazing. Ron, what are you going to ask Tim?
Yeah, Tim, new for this spring of 19, you've got a new Freestyle custom fit glove. You know, tell our listeners about this glove because it's pretty unique in the fact that, you know, a lot of people say, well, they don't, you know, one glove doesn't fit all. But you've come up with this new Freestyle custom fit glove. Tell our listeners about it.
Right. And Ron, thanks. Yeah, thanks for bringing that one up. So it's called the Freestyle Glove. And basically, it's, again, it's in our Guide Glove series. So it's going to give you your sun protection on the back of your hand. The palm of it is made of a synthetic leather. And then we do a silicone treatment to it, so it's got phenomenal grip. But the unique thing about the glove is we've had all these requests, people saying, oh, I like certain fingers removed or cut out and certain fingers in, and everybody having their own kind of little design idea. And so what we did is we came up with a style that you can actually cut the individual fingers off of the gloves that you want.
Yeah, this is cool.
And we've double-stitched on the inside of those fingers so that when you cut them off at the designated area, they won't split or fray. So that way, if you want to have your right hand completely covered and your left hand with a couple of the fingers out, you can actually just cut them off and customize it for the way you want it or whatever your fit or need might be. So it's been received extremely well. The bass markets loved it, and we've got it involved in other markets as well. But it's been received very well, and the reviews from our pros have been outstanding on it.
Well, I have to admit, like the pair I've got on now, I really enjoy – I don't enjoy it, but I'm on my yard wearing these things, okay?
No, that's good for you.
I've got a real good – it's a good grip.
Good grip,
It doesn't feel cumbersome or anything like that.
They're not hot.
No. And if I've got to well, I won't go that far. But if I've got a nose that itches or something like that, that's my finger touching me, okay? That's not something else that happens. And, again, we're talking to Tim Mossberg from our good friends at Fish Monkey. And, you know, I had somebody I was wearing, and my neighbor came up to me and wondered, wow, where'd you get those gloves? And then he saw the name, and like I told Tim off the air, Ron has picked me up a couple of Fish Monkey shirts, what I'm wearing out. The monkey's starting to look a little ragged, you know, because I wear them all the time. But tell our listeners, before we get all the information, I'll let Ron ask that. That's part of his job on the show. But I've got the name. Tell our listeners that maybe not know the little history about this, and you're based out of that, what we call Little Memphis down there in Destin. So talk a little bit about Fish Monkey.
So the name, you know, when we were coming up with the concept of the gloves, the whole thing about the gloves was something that would provide a great grip. And you think about, you know, what has a better grip of any animal out there than a monkey?
That's right.
So that was kind of the idea, that monkeys got a great grip.
Don't ever shake hands with a monkey. I can tell you that for a fact. You're going to lose.
They've got a good grip. They don't slip.
No, they don't.
So the whole idea was, you know, you got a great monkey with a good monkey grip, and obviously just tying it into fishing, which is my passion.
Yes. Yeah.
So the name kind of stuck. So that's kind of that was the
well,
starting of the name.
So. Well, we're going to let you go, but it's really I like with the hook in the middle of the fish, the logo. It's just pretty cool, and you know, I swear that's my cousin, that monkey on the front there. It looks just like my cousin. I haven't seen him in years. But, hey, Tim, thank you, buddy. We'll talk to you. We'll talk to you, and we're going to work with you as a field what are we going to be, field guides out here in Memphis?
You're going to be our field testers, our
field staff.
Yeah, when that floppy hat comes out, I'm the one, okay?
And about, Tim, you're going to be at ICAS.
Yes, sir. We will be there.
Okay, we'll see in about 15 seconds.
Yeah, Bill will be there. Ron will be there.
Give us an idea of what we might see.
Yeah.
In about 15 seconds here.
You got something new to go show down there real quickly?
Yeah, so at ICAST, we're launching a whole new line of heavy winter ice gloves. So we'll be debuting those, and we've got about 5 or 6 items new that work within that category. So we'll debuting those at ICAST.
All right, buddy.
Sounds like good duck hunting gloves.
Yeah, duck. That's what you're thinking about.
Absolutely.
Yeah, it is. Ice gloves.
We don't get the ice fish here.
Yeah, that's right, yeah. Hey, thank you, Tim, and have a great Memorial weekend, and you know we'll stay in touch. We're your fish monkey people, okay?
I appreciate it, guys. Y'all have a great holiday as well.
Thank you. All right, Tim Mossberg. Let me tell you about next week's show because it will be first Saturday. It's hard to believe. Golly, where did May go? You know, I just had a birthday again. Okay, Dave Gabbert will be with us next week, and Gene Smith, the award-winning Gene Smith, will be in studio.
That's right.
To talk outdoors with Dave and Gene. I got some surprise guests that we're going to sink right in there to you, putting together June's guest, and it won't be long before the FLW will be here, and Ron will be getting all these anglers together, and it just, it's busy. Thank you, Bill. What you got going?
Thank you, Larry. Well, first of all, folks, pray for everybody in Louisiana, because all this water in the Mississippi River, it's close to some bad stuff happening if we don't get some luck. And
I got a lot of friends down that area.
On the politics side, I wanted to mention this.
Tell us.
When the budget came out not long ago, President Trump had struck $200 million for the Everglades from it.
Uh-huh. Well.
Now he's put it back. And this is what we've been shooting for the last couple of years, what Gordo and I went to Washington, D.C. to talk about last year. And
there you go.
So the president, fortunately, he listened to sportsmen.
Well, he does that.
Yes, he does.
$200 million, and Florida has their $200 million. It's going to be that every year until they get it fixed.
All right.
Awesome.
Ron, you be careful this weekend, okay?
I'll be here, there, yonder. Check out LROutdoors.com for pictures of events.
That's right. And this is Larry Ray reminding you to do each and every week. It doesn't cost an extra cent to be a good sport. And what else?
God bless the USA.